Welcome back to Zero Art Brands, and hi friends, this is Sonia here, their guest design team, and I'm super excited to share this new video tutorial where we are going to do decoupage on this MDF wall clock. This is a beautiful decoupage paper design from our very own collection of Zero Brands, and I thought of doing this wall clock and decoupage technique, and let's get started. So first I'm going to do some fussy cutting work, and I love this postcard pattern, although I really hate cutting the extra part, but yes, I have to. So I'm going to fussy cut this postcard and just see how it matches with my clock, the size wise and the design wise, and then I'm going to start with the next process. As it's a decoupage paper, so it's a little thicker than the tissues what you get, and it's really easy to do fussy cutting on these. So you can just grab your favorite scissor and start cutting it. Once you're done with your fussy cutting work, please mark it with a pencil on your MDF base so that you know where exactly you have to do the coloring. Here I'm using a chalk paint to do a nice color on my base, and I'm using my sponge dauber to make sure that my color is evenly spread and it looks good. Make sure you cover all the remaining spaces of the wall clock base, which is going to be visible on some portion. We are going to have our paper, the remaining portion is going to be very much visible, so please make sure you apply your colors very nicely. Here I'm going to use two blending colors of chalk paint, and you can play around with the colors. You can choose the amazing color design and papers from Zero Brands, and then you can accordingly decide on the colors. Here I'm going to use my peach color and fade lemon yellow color chalk paint. You can really play around with the colors. You can add as much as color you want to add. It's time to move on to the next step. I really can't leave without stamping. I really love stamping. So here I am going to use this Cricut stamp on my base to give it a nice dip. Time to stick your papers, and for this we will be needing matte finish Mod Podge, and I'm going to apply a generous amount of Mod Podge on my base, and then I'm going to stick my paper. I will be using my sponge dauber to make sure that there are no bubbles. Anyways, with the Zero Brand decoupage papers, your decoupage technique becomes really easy because your paper has a perfect thickness, the perfect hardness, so that there are very less bubbles, and at times there are no bubbles. Time to remove the extra paper. You can always fold them, but I really wanted to cut this particular curved portion. I did not want it to fold it. So here with my craft knife, I'm going to give a nice cut to it. Before moving to the next step, I am going to mark my hole on my base, and this is how I am going to have a nice hole on my base so that I can fix up my mechanism at last. Now it's time to add some more colors to it, and for that I'm going to use shimmer spray. You can also play around with another shades of chalk paint, add some water to it, and you can always dab them and have some sprinkle of your colors on your base. Adding some more definition to your paper really highlights them. So here I'm using dye-based ink pad and I'm just going to highlight my paper borders. So for this I'm going to use my blending tool. Again, this is available with us. You can check the varieties of options we have in blending tools, and it's really easy and a cool way to highlight your paper. Once I'm done with my blending color, it's time to add a little more definition to my clock. So instead of using any wooden alphabet or numbers to my clock, I thought of using the texture paste, and I am going to add some colors to my texture paste to make sure that I have my perfect color for my Shabachik theme wall clock. Once I'm happy with the color I want to, I am going to use this texture paste and add the timing to my clock. So here I'm just going to have 12, 3, 6 and 9. So this is going to look perfect for my clock. decoupage with a bit of shading work looks really awesome. So here I'm going to use my same shade, the dark brown color, and with my finger dauber I'm going to highlight my papers, and then I'm also going to highlight my edges with my numbers. This step can be done only when your texture paste has dried out completely. If it is still wet, please let it dry completely so that your texture paste does not smudge on your base. My clock is almost ready and it's time to add my sealer to it. So here I'm going to apply a coat of Mod Podge, the matte finish Mod Podge, so to make sure that my paper does not changes my color, my work does not changes over the time. So please make sure you apply a generous amount of Mod Podge, which is really important to have your paper, your color, your look and finish as it is over the time. Later on I thought of adding some more elements to it, so here again I'm going to use this custom made stamp and I am going to add a little border to my timings. So you can use any of your stamp. Here I'm using my permanent ink pad and I am going to add borders to it. Once I'm done with the stamping work, I am going to use my final sealer, that is Asian Paints liquid wood varnish, and I am going to apply a generous coat of varnish on my clock. Now for the top layer, I'm going to have two layers. Please make sure when you are applying your second layer, your first base has dried out completely. Second thing is, I am going to apply only one coat of varnish on my backing, cause that is something which is not going to be visible at all. But still, for the protective reasons, I am going to apply one layer of wood varnish to that also. Once your sealer has dried out completely, it's time to add the final mechanism to it. Installing this mechanism is really easy. Just open up the screws and fix up the dialers and it's done. So this brings my project to an end, and I'm really happy with the way it has turned out, and I'm super happy with the way I could create this beautiful wall clock with zero brand decoupage papers. Supplies used in this video are mentioned in the description box below. Do check that. If you have any queries, please do comment below. We will be really happy to help you guys and guide you as much as we can. And do not forget to subscribe and share this with your friends. Thank you so much for watching.